Hello, hello. It's Dinosaurceress, and I'm here to give you a tour on October. I know it's been a couple days, but I figured I would show you anyway. Talk about my drawings, and the products that I used, and everything else. So let's get started. So I used the prompt list, the official Inktober prompt list from Jake Parker, who's the creator of this. I'll link something down below, maybe. So the days are as follows, I guess. Maybe I'll put captions on the screen. I don't know. So the first day was Swift, and I decided that it would be funny to do something that is not so swift, and so I drew two slugs racing. I think I used a Pentel fountain pen and some scented inks and things like that, and just had a little fun in general. And then I think I used my Copic Gassin Fude pen to leave the shadows or whatever. And then so the second day was Divided, and so I did this girl who's kind of like pulling back her face to reveal how divided her thoughts were. So one side with gray black thorns and one side with blooming flowers and leaves and things like that. And I was really trying to do like some cross hatching for like shading, and trying to use as minimum color as possible and things like that. But I am a whore for color, so I added some gold, and I did accidentally rub my hand against it, so there's a little dribble here, but you know, whatever, it happens. Oh, I guess I should say that the goal of Inktober for me was to use only ink and no Copics, because those are kind of my comfort zone, I guess, even though I still am very new to them. But no Copics whatsoever, just ink, and use as many new techniques and utensils and things that I can. So sometimes I'll use ink washes. These are like, some of this is done with ink wash. Some of these are done with like cross hatching. Some is done with just a regular technical pen. Some is done with ink wells. Some with, I tried to use like a dip pen for some, but this paper is very thin, and is not meant for drawing or wet media at all. I didn't think that I would finish, so I didn't want to use an expensive sketchbook that I wasn't going to use, but I ended up finishing the entire Inktober challenge or whatever. So maybe next year, if I do it, I will use something much better and come up with much better pieces. Anyway, moving forward, so day two is Divided, day three was Poison, and so I tried coming up with a lot of different ideas. It's kind of hard to tell here, but I wanted to try to be a little creative, so I ended up coming up with like a poisonous lipstick, and you can't tell that it's poisonous, but I tried to like make the leaves around it look dead, and I tried to draw like a cup of some sort that fell with like lipstick on it, to try to convey that the person might have either put the lipstick on and drink from the glass, and either the contents of the glass were the ones that was what was poisoned, or the lipstick itself was poisoned and just didn't act right away, kind of thing. So it's trying to like a mysterious kind of tone to it. I don't know if that came across, but you know, that's what it is. And now for day four was Underwater, and I had a lot of fun doing this. I looked up so many different references and like just stuff in general about octopi, or actually the correct term is octopuses. I need to refocus my vocabulary, but I did so much research and I learned so much about them, and I had a lot of fun drawing this, and I kind of want to do more octopuses in the future. So maybe we'll see some eventually. And then the next day, day five, was long. So what can be longer than a giant snake wrapped around itself? This one was obnoxious in the fact that I did a few scales, and then I was like, well, it won't look right if I do some scales and not everywhere else. So I ended up doing like the whole thing, and then I was tired. But then I had put so much in that I had to finish, and by the end of the day I was like so tired, but it was so worth it because it looks so cool, at least in my opinion. And then I did some hatching, not necessarily cross hatching, there is some, but some of it is just regular hatching, so yeah. And then for day six, sorry if I mess up, I didn't write these down. Day six was sword, and I really wanted to do it like this. I know the sword isn't the focal point of it, but I've actually always wanted a tattoo of like a sword like stuck in a bed or a bouquet of flowers or something to like for symbolize. So I did part of that for this. And my favorite flower is actually the gladiola, or gladiolus, whatever. And as I was looking up all different kinds and varieties and what is it, genuses, I think they're called, I found like the black star gladiola, which is like black on the edges and then like a dark, deep blood red, like all throughout the rest. And so I really like these. And the reason why I love gladiolas are because they mean strength, and they're actually, I think it's like Latin for like sword or something like that. So I really like that, and I figure it pairs really well with an actual sword. And then I use, I think these are orchids? You know what? I have no idea what these flowers are called. Peonies? No. They're some kind of flower, and it meant strength or something. And I didn't want to do just a bunch of gladiolas. So there's that. And then, oops, skipping a day. And then for six, seven was shy. I tried to do like a creepy doll, and then the anatomy was super wrong, and I just didn't understand it. But this is what it came to be as. Whatever. Not much to say about that. And then this was crooked. So I drew a witch with a crooked nose, and she looks a little forlorn, just because, I don't know, maybe she's misunderstood or something like that. But she's beautiful and everything, so why would she be so sad? I don't know. And then I used some like negative space, since it's all black, to like really accentuate the lines and folds and things like that, and tried to like use highlights. I used just a white Jelly Roll pen. I consider it to be ink, so we'll go with that. Anyway, moving forward. Next day was screech, so I drew a screech owl or something that looks like a screech owl, hopefully. I did this actually I think while I was in Vegas for like family vacation kind of thing. I did it at night after we were like done kind of doing whatever. So, but I also wanted to just go to sleep, so I also used it as a chance to give myself some freedom. And I don't like creating messy pictures. I know some people do it just amazingly well and it looks beautiful, and I've never been happy with it. So I used this day as an excuse to make my own little messy drawing. So I like, there's a bunch of like scratchy lines and a lot of like just scribbles to kind of make it kind of come to life. And I'm actually really proud with how this turned out. I probably won't do another piece like this where it's just kind of thrown together. But I was really happy that I tried it at least. And that's probably like the theme for pretty much everything here. And then next, I think was giant, this was. And so I tried to draw like a dollhouse and like, you know, one of those little fake wooden dolls or whatever as a silhouette. And a child or woman or something looking through the glass, so you can see like her head kind of showing through. And it might not be like the most accurate, like, if you plan it out, but yeah. And then so I wanted to do just like add some color, because again, I like color and kind of go crazy if I don't have a lot. So I used a pink and green really thin gel pen to like make it look like a what is the word? Wallpaper or something that you would see in a dollhouse. So I thought it was cute though. This one is probably one of my favorites, actually. I really like this one. This one was for Run, and I pretty much just used, I think I used a technical pen, like a Copic multiliner, and then I used a Copic Gas Infused, and then two little bits of gel pen here. I had a lot of fun with this. I used so much reference to try to figure out how a body looks running, and so I put in a lot of effort for this, and I don't usually do a lot of, like, facial variants, I guess, and like expressions. It's probably something I should work on. But I really like this one. This one's definitely one of my favorites. And then the next one, this is Shattered. So it's a picture of a girl sitting in front of her locker, surrounded by everyone else's love and everything. And you can see she has a torn up photo of like her and like her ex or something like that. She's probably gotten her heart broken on Valentine's Day or near Valentine's Day at least. And then like this is supposed to be like, you know, the crumpled up note kind of thing. So I really like this. I don't like how this happened because I used the wrong pen in some areas, so the ink kind of bled. Because I guess this is. I don't plan things ahead of time, so I didn't know that the fountain pen, the Pentel fountain pen that I use, the ink is not waterproof. Copic is, which is what I did with all of these to get super straight lines, but the fountain pen is not. So that is something to definitely note for the future, and that I learned to possibly plan ahead. Maybe. We'll see. And then this one I also really like. I've never drawn a skull before. So this one was Teeming, and so I really wanted to kind of step out of my comfort zone, and it took me forever to figure out what to do for this. I was like, teeming with what? I don't understand. So it's just a bunch of like earthworms or worms in general, like teeming around a skull kind of thing. I think it looks really freaking cool. I even like added texture by like blotting ink on it and then like picking it up with my finger, so it looks like really authentic slash unplanned and dirty kind of thing. So I really freaking love this one too. And then the next one, this one is Fierce. Again, I had just got back from Vegas, so I saw a Zoomanity, and I was going to add a beard here, but then I was afraid of messing up the face, so I, like, shaved him, I guess you could say, and I kind of regret doing that, because I really should have just done the challenge and done the beard or whatever, but I did, like, add some jewelry and stuff like that to kind of make it look more fierce. So this is supposed to be, like, claw nails on a ball kind of thing for an earring, and then instead of like red like he had in the show, his name was Brandon, I think. I made it purple instead because I have a purple Copic multiliner that I wanted to use. So that was that. And then the next day was what was after Fierce? Mysterious. So this one was Mysterious, so I used a mask with a bunch of stuff and jewels around it, kind of like a masquerade. It's mysterious, you don't know who's behind it. I like the idea of this one. I don't like necessarily how I executed it, but I do like that I really committed to the details here in the, like, the net. I think the net is my favorite part of this, but everything else is just kind of but yeah, so there's that. And then the next day was Fat, and I just, you know, I draw humans normally, and I don't draw a lot of animals, but I didn't want to, like, draw, like, a fat human or something like that, because I like all body shapes and everything, but I don't like that word, so I just drew a fat cat, because he won't get offended. He knows he is. So I guess. But yeah. So I just did like is a cop out drawing, and I kind of apologize for it, but I also don't regret it. So I used like pure gel pens, like really fine point gel pens for this, and called it a day. And then the next day was graceful, and I had a lot of different ideas. One was like a fairy of some sort, or ice skater, or just a child playing, or like a princess walking down the stairs. But then I like came up with like, you know, like kind of like Swift, where like I didn't want to do anything that was like Swift per se. So I decided instead to do like something that isn't so graceful. So like a child pretending to be graceful while like walking along the edge of a fence or something like that, or like a concrete wall or whatever, like pretending to be like a trapeze artist or like a ballerina or a gymnast or something like that. So I thought this was cute. Not really fond of like how it looks up here necessarily, but the idea was fun. And I used just the fountain pen for this one. And then this one was filthy, I think it was the word. So I tried to convey like a filthy ocean/beach. I didn't really put any filth in the sand or whatever, but I tried to make this look green and brown and less blue, whereas the sky is blue, to kind of convey the difference here. And then like kind of proud of the wood fence that I did here in front, but otherwise it was just an okay drawing, I think. It's already sideways. Mm-hmm. Okay. So this one I did for, what was the word now? I can remember most of them, because I spent so much. Oh, this one is cloud. So this, I tried to draw an angel. Mm-hmm. I don't really draw wings very often. I kind of hate drawing wings because they make me a little uncomfortable. But I wanted to draw like a little angel just relaxing in a bed of purple clouds, and you know, and so I used just purple ink, and then I like used the pure ink for this, and then kind of watered it down for everything else. And I didn't want to initially have these, but I'm using the wrong paper, so I put down the purple, and then I went back to get water to water it down, and it was already like soaked into the paper, so I couldn't move it anymore. Mm-hmm. So that's just how this turned out. But you know, it still, I think, looks pretty good for what it is. The pose might be a little off, but it was really hard to get a reference for this pose that I wanted, and so I just kind of did it myself. This one I also really, really love. I think I might turn this into like an actual Copic drawing of sorts. And this is for Deep. So mm-hmm. Deep underground is a rock whale who sneezes or something and shoots like fire/molten rock lava up into a volcano, and that's what happens when a volcano erupts. I thought it was really funny of a story, and then he's got little like crystals and everything, and it's, you can't really see it, but like I tried to make them sparkle with a metallic gel pen or whatever. But I think one day I might want to make this into like a bigger drawing, and I might actually do this for Jazz's next challenge, because it's supposed to be like under the surface, and this would be, I think, a really great piece to use for that. So maybe you'll see something later. We'll see. I can make no promises. And then this day, you can see I like have some red here because I had a completely different concept at first. But this was Furious, I believe. Yeah, Furious. And I wanted to do like, you can see the red. I wanted to do like a woman like kneeling over like a fallen friend or something like that, who was just angry and wanted to take revenge. But I I was running out of time. I couldn't get the pose right, so I was like, I'm just gonna draw a face that looks really angry. And then I put like a mirror around her, and I was like, oh, she looks like a banshee type, like ghost kind of thing. And she's just pissed off because she's trapped in a mirror. So that's what I went with, and then I added gold around the edges. So I think it looks kind of cool. She kind of ended up looking like a character from a Scooby-Doo movie, and maybe that was secretly in my subconscious. But yep, there's that. And then so this one was for trail. This one was for trail. And it's a person kind of walking down the trail, bending down, finding like a trail of popcorn. And I was trying to like scratch in words. You probably can't see that, but I just wanted to draw like a cute girl walking down like a path or whatever and finding a trail of popcorn and trying to see where it is going to lead to. I kind of really like the idea of this again. I don't like how big her head is for her body. And the pose is a little weird, but after a while I just kind of gave up because again I was running out of time, so whatever. And then this one is for Juicy, so she's got a juicy little butt that she's kind of showing off or whatever. And as she's wearing a dress that has an apple pattern, so juicy apples, juicy booty, you know. I thought it was fun. And then this one was for blind, and so I kind of like the idea of this, and I colored it in with a white gel pen and then gold ink. But it's supposed to be, you know, justice, you know, the phrase justice is blind, but I really don't think so. I think it's not so much, so that's why her blindfold is kind of, she's peeking underneath it to kind of manipulate the scales to her benefit or however she sees fit. So it's kind of almost like a political statement or something, but I'm not trying to get into that necessarily. This one I really love. I tried not to do any fan art necessarily, but of course there was the Brandon from Zumanity and then this. But I had to do this, and I really, so I got inspiration from Juicy Ink. She's a YouTuber that I follow. She does really beautiful watercolor stuff, but she does a lot where she puts the watercolor down and creates like this pattern and design or whatever, and then she inks on top of that. So I kind of wanted to do something like that, knowing exactly how I wanted it to kind of look. So, but I used just a simple ink wash and like put in the sh like blocked in the shapes, let it dry, then added like shadows, let it dry, and then kept adding for the look that I wanted it to have. And then based on that, I drew the lines and everything. So that's why, like, this is supposed to be Ash and Serena. So this is for the word ship. So it's a, you know, if you ship a couple and like in an anime or whatever, it's because you like their relationship or you want them to get together. So I thought this was a funny take on it. And just again, a new technique to try. And I had a lot of fun with it. So maybe I'll explore that later in a way in the future or something. But for now, I'm kind of tired of inks. Anyway, moving on. This was a squeak. And the only thing I could think of was either a mouse or a squeaky floorboard, but I didn't know how to do that necessarily. So I thought, oh, like an ant getting squished could like squeak because he might be screaming to himself, but you might hear it as only like a little squeak because he's a tiny little guy. So it's a image of a like child's foot kind of about to step on him, and he's like, no, don't. It was fun and cute, and I used brown like Higgins ink, and I think I used a Prismacolor brush pen that I've just had lying around for a while. This video is getting really long, and I'm sorry, but you know what? I haven't posted in a while, so I guess take what you can get. Anyway, this was for climb, and I had a lot of fun with this. I brought the black cat suit kind of thing from the run day. I don't like how her face came out at all, but it's something that I'm still working on. But I do like how like the pose and everything kind of worked out, and like I don't know, the concept, I guess. Again, it's always concept, but reality, it sucks. But so yeah, I did this and I put shoes on her this time instead of walking barefoot. So maybe she was climbing up something and then she got caught and then was running away. And what we're seeing is the reverse in time. I don't know. I just thought it was fun. And this one is for, ooh, I forgot the date again. Oh, for fall. So I was going to do like some, like a picture of someone like falling down a well or something, but again, excuses. Couldn't figure out the pose, couldn't figure out the perspective and things like that. And then as I was looking at like Google image references, I found like, I saw like one of like a man holding his woman, you know, kind of those classic, that classic pose. So I decided to kind of take that idea and then put like, you know, a woman being held by another woman, and it, she's dressed in like a nightgown of sorts, and she's a very posh woman. So like maybe she works for her and they really like each other, and she fell while she was cleaning, and I don't know, I tried to come up with like a whole little story as I was drawing them. But I really like this one. I thought it was really cute. I also like how her hair is kind of like flopped over her face to kind of signify that it's a little messy from the fall kind of thing. Anyway, so that was that. And then this was United. This one I had a really hard time coming up with an idea, but then I just started drawing and this happened. And I only did one other witch during October. So I decided to draw a witch, and she's naked but kind of like, you know, holding her heart like slash her chest kind of thing. And like, I don't know, unifying with herself. And like, I think what I posted on Instagram or something was like, you know, a witch has to be united, mind, heart, and body kind of thing in order to perform powerful magic. So she's like making sure all of her stuff is aligned, I guess, or slash united. So I like the idea of this. Some of the stuff didn't come out the way that I wanted it to, so like the eyes are a little lopsided, which is kind of always a problem for me anyway, but I really like the idea of this, and I might explore something like this later on, at least the pose or something. Maybe not a witch because it's no longer October, but we'll see. And then this one, I was desperately in need of color. This is still all ink, but so I put together a mermaid. I've never drawn a mermaid before, mm-hmm. and I've always wanted to, so this was my excuse, and it was the word for the word found. As you can see, my pen wasn't working for a little bit because whatever. So I drew some, like, I drew a mermaid finding a pearl in a clamshell, and so she's about to kind of grab it so that she can take it to use for whatever she needs to use it for. So that was just that, not much to talk about. Basically, like I said, I used all ink for this, and maybe I'll show you what I had after. And then this was the final day. The final day was mask. So I drew like a little superhero boy, wearing like a galaxy suit, because again, color, I wanted to use my purples and my blues and a little bit of red, and I used my black, and then I used some gel pens to kind of make it look starry and everything, and I had him in a pose like, ta-da, it's done, and that was the idea behind this. It's a little messy, like I kind of smudged some stuff towards the end there, but and then I put him like in a golden background because again I just kind of wanted to use everything that I could for the last day, although I only used a couple of items in general, but yeah, that was it, all 31 days, my first Inktober, and it was a success. And I used a Moleskine journal, so it's not even a sketchbook. So like I said, it is the thinnest paper ever. It is not meant for watercolors or wet media ever at all, but surprisingly enough, it held up with water very well. Like, I had no tears, no like rubbing, I guess. I don't know what the term is for that. No paper felt kind of, you know what I mean. I had none of that, and so I was pretty surprised, although it is very like wavy, as you can see here, like the water did warp it a lot. But all in all, like, it held up pretty darn well. So although it wasn't the best material that I used, this journal actually worked really well. But like I said, if I do another challenge like this, I definitely plan on using at least better paper so that I can then also create better art. This video is like 30 minutes and I don't plan on really editing it that much, if at all. So I'm probably not gonna talk about what I use or anything like that. But I do want to give a couple shout outs here. I forgot to mention that this piece here was kind of inspired by Katie Did's art style, who also did Inktober. She's a great YouTuber that I absolutely love watching, and she's so super, super duper sweet. So if you are watching this, hello! I also, like, I did Inktober alongside a couple of other YouTubers that were doing it, like Kelsadelphia, which, by the way, it took me forever to figure out what that username meant, but anyway, I digress. She did videos every day, and posted to Instagram every day and stuff like that. So between her and Katie and all the other YouTubers and things like that, I really felt like I had friends doing this along with me, and I think that's what helped push me to finish the entire month, because as you know from the lack of videos in the past however many months, I don't even want to know. I have no discipline with myself when it comes to like these kinds of hobbies, so I'm really proud of myself for sticking through this month, even though it's not the best art whatsoever. I experimented with techniques and products and things that I never would have before, and I have a new love for inks, especially like the Daler Rowney FW inks. I used this the most, so I highly, highly recommend this. It is so freaking good. Like, half a drop of this and a little bit of water just lasts so much, and it's still like almost pure black when you use it. So like, this is just fantastic, and you know I love opaque colors and stuff like that. So like, this is just fantastic. I could not recommend this anymore. Like, it is about like $6-ish or so, whole price, I guess. But it is so worth it. I feel like I've barely used any of this, and I used it throughout the entire month. So I cannot recommend this brand enough. Thanks for watching, if you did watch, and thanks anyway if you are watching, and maybe I'll post something in the future. We'll see. No guarantees. Bye!